So, here's the bit. And I've already done my research on this. So, we can see that the circuits are a bit worn out. Let's use that word for just to not say some other not so pleasant word. Let's get some light. Okay, so as you can see from the picture, I have a fair bit of corrosion on this side of the clock circuit. However, there's only a few elements that look like they may have an issue. So there's a diode here. Let me see if I can get something to point with. Okay, so we have a diode here. It looks to be okay, but we can test it easily. And we have this resistor that we can't even read what it is, but we know from the shape that it's a resistor. So we need to check if that one is working as well. And we have plenty of corrosion here, but we'll just look at the first culprit and see what we can do about it. And here's an interesting thing, because I already opened this, I can tell you. On the opposite side, we have this. So this is a 1 watt, 150 ohms resistor, or so it says in the packaging. And as you can see, it's connected to this and this pole. So that resistor, it's quite black on the back. It looks like it's burned out. So we can give it a test. So if we connect those two pins, can we read anything? And we read 150. So if we can get a connection, there we go. So that resistor is good, even though it's a bit dark, and it looks like it's overheating. It probably will need replacing, and probably will need replacing with some higher wattage resistor. I do not know. I have asked the gurus, and I'm waiting for their reply. However, we have this other resistor. Now, I have a spare clock from my other car, and I have opened this just to find out what the hell is this, because, well, let's face it, you can't read what that is. And this is supposed to be a 100k resistor. So if I set my multimeter to 20 million, I should be able to read 100k here, assuming that the resistor is working. But I can't read anything. Now, I don't know if it's the connections that are crappy or not, so let's just confirm that the connections that I can actually connect somewhere. So let's just check for continuity in two places that I know are the same connection. So here's the thing, I can't even... This is supposed to be solder. Okay, there's solder here, so I can't even connect from the solder to the resistor itself. So it's possible that the corrosion is just... Oh, there is something. We got something there. Maybe scraping a bit. So I got solder. Apparently this resistor is not even connected to this side. The breakage... Oh, there's something. No? No, I'm touching the bottom, so that's not right. Okay, it's possible that this resistor is just broken, that the resistor may be fine, but just the connection to the blob of solder is corroded through. And the other side, I can't get any connection either. Not even through the solder. Okay, so Let's try scraping some of that out. Maybe it will clean off a bit. I'm just very, very, very gently brushing, hoping to remove some of the stuff around it. Okay, I did get a connection there. Okay. So I know that this is a point that it's good to test. So I just need to find out if this is a good point. Yeah, I can't actually find continuity between its own blob of solder. So what I'm going to try is to put a bit of flux there, heat it up, and then we'll try to see if reflowing that solder gives us any kind of helpful result. So I have some flux here. Just gonna put a generous amount of flux in both sides. Top up my iron. And I think this bit is not the right bit for this task, so I'm going to replace the bit as well. Okay. Well, let's just start this off. Okay. Now, I'm going to lean the camera sideways, because this is a lot of heat and I don't know if this is going to damage the camera or if there is a risk of damaging the camera. I have some solder. This should be okay to reflux now. So let's see if it works. I may need to add some new solder to it. I do not know. Okay, I'm gonna need a bit more power to reflow this. Yes, we are now reflowing. Okay, so this side is now reflowed. Now the other side, I'm gonna see if I can pull that. That wire to the side. Okay, that has been reflowed as well now. And we may probably have a burnt resistor now. But that's okay, because I have a replacement in case I need one. So let's see if we now have a connection. This is very, very interesting. It appears that the leg of the resistor is just not conducting any electricity at all. Now, I find it very strange that the leg of the resistor itself doesn't record anything. Okay, it is working now. Okay, so we have connection on one side and we have connection on the other side, so we can now test the resistor itself. And we have 430 ohms resistance. Apparently. Now 430 ohms resistance, or is it 400,000? So I'm changing the range just to confirm, because I don't know how to use this multimeter. Right. So we have 400. Thousand. Across. Now, I believe that what I read from this one was that it was supposed to be 100K and not 400K. So right now, I'm just going to take this apart and test this one to confirm. Okay, so there is the resistor. Let's check that one out. That's a lot closer to the 100K that I was expecting to see. This is actually 20% off. This resistor probably needs changing as well, as it's out of its boundaries. I can see a gold line through it, which I believe means it's a 5% margin. Now this has the same color code resistor. They actually look the same apart from the brown being thicker. And this reads 94. So we have a resistor here that it's quite far from what it's supposed to be, and one resistor here that is just way off. So this needs replacing. I'm going to replace this resistor. So let's remove this resistor, replace it with this one. So just a little bit more flux in there. And let's see if I can remove this. Okay, I think that hole is now cleaned. So a bit of flux on the other side. Continuing on the excitement from yesterday, my phone ran out of space to do some recording, so I had to stop. So I believe I was in the middle of desoldering this. So let's have a go at this.
I seem to be in the position of needing more flux. Okay.
There we go. Oh, that is quite a damage resistor. Right. So let's see if we can take this apart without damaging anything. There you go. Attaboy. So just that tiny bit there. Okay, so here's my 100k resistor that I put on a side yesterday to replace it. Now the interesting thing about this that I've noticed yesterday, well, that I've noticed just now, is that the old resistor was not actually plugged through either of the holes. I have no idea why, but it was connected to them, so I'm gonna go for the through-hole installation anyway. This may be a mistake, but then again, if something is already broken, you can't break it anymore. So let's shorten these legs. Okay, legs have been shortened. Out if this resistor still does 100k. Oh, it's down to 75, just like the one on the other. Thing, that's okay. And we got a diode here, which is still working fine if I just connect to the correct place. Yeah, nothing and something. Yep, so we should be good. Hopefully that diode is actually connected somewhere. It may be broken. I am not sure. Yeah, that seems to be connected. So let's give this a go. Okay, we have now 12 volts here. Which we want to connect to, I guess, block. Let's try to follow some kind of coding. At least not make the red the block, because that's just bad practice. So we got block for ground. Connected to ground in here, which is that plug. And now we have one here for the red. Black. And now the final one, I don't know if it's supposed to be green or orange. Now, I'm gonna try each one in turn and see if I get any results. Well, green gives me nothing. Orange achieves nothing. So let's start by confirming that there is something going in. There and there. We have 12 volts there, okay. Right. Let's give the orange a try. I believe that's the orange one. Oh, we're down to 5 volts. That is odd. That is very odd. Ah, we're on 12 there, but on the other side of the flux we're down, we're still on 12. And then we drop to 5. And that really looks like the place where this diode should be connected. So maybe we need to replace this diode as well. So let's have a look at what the functioning clock can tell us. Oh, so that diode is not connected there. And the diode is not connected to the resistor either. So there may be a short between those two in here. That may be something that needs to be addressed. There. The end of that diode and that, they may be connected, and that would not be a good idea. So let's give that a go, just to see if there's something there for us to... Okay, I think I need to reflow this flux because I can't even get conductivity within itself. So let's reflow that first, and then see what comes out of it. I gotta say that diode looks broken to me. I tried to remove one side and the other came out. Okay, we got clean connections. We have a diode that we need to figure out what its value is. There's a 0, a 7. IN4007. I believe this is one of the most common diodes out there. Rectifier diodes. Which I think it's this 4007. That started with a 4, didn't it? Yes, IN4007. Yep, it is just one of the most common rectifier diodes, which thankfully I have in stock because of a project that I have worked on previously. So there we are. The direction is this, so I just need to bend it, cut the tips, make things work, reflow, and we're on to try this again. There we go. Clean connection. Right. Come on, finish off that burning. Okay. Should be just worked hot enough now. That looks like a good solder joint. Now I'm just going to tin this wire and then connect it on the top. Now I personally don't think that's the best way to connect something, but right now I'm just trying to see if I can get things to touch each other. And this should be enough to keep things connected. So I am now going to confirm that there's no short circuits between the two and that things are still working together. And with the back of the sponge, just going to clean this a bit. Mostly because the rosin Seems to be all over the place. And I just realized that that was not the most intelligent thing to do. Some contact cleaner from a no longer running company, why not? It won't do any harm. It also helps to displace the water that I just put through and then evaporates afterwards, so... So let's find out what the multimeter says now. So does the diode work in both directions? We have one direction working and the other direction no connection at all. So that's good. Now let's just confirm that this blob of solder is not connected to anything else nearby. Lovely. Awesome. Let's just confirm that one as well. Okay. But within itself, it's connecting. Okay. Next thing. Next thing, I believe, should be the orange wire. Confirm if it's connecting. It does connect. So we got power going into there now. Now, the resistor, does it still work? Yes, and it reads the 77. Now, I know that this resistor here reads 77 as well. So I believe this is set up in a parallel with something else, which drops the 100. K to 77, 80-ish. So I'm not going to worry about that because of the way of its... It makes sense to be like this under certain circumstances. So let's just give this another go. Let's give ourselves some power on the red and black wires and just confirm that power is still working. So red, black. Right, we're on 12 volts, good. Now this should be the orange wire getting some power now. So orange to black, and we got 12 volts. Okay, let's see what the display shows. And there you go. I have successfully repaired a 30-year-old digital clock. Now, if we short the power with the green wire, we should have a dim functionality, which I would like to confirm is working. Okay. 12 volts on this red wire, why not? And now the green wire is there. So, did it dim? It did not dim. Should it dim? Yes. It should, I believe. So let's just do a little test first. Yes, we have 12 volts. There we go, it did dim. So this is a fully functional Elan digital clock. So I am very, very pleased with this result. In order to repair this, all I needed was two small components and a template to follow.